Can you conclude that the average duration of unemployment in Houston is less than 32 weeks during July 2013? All right, so this is not a proposition question. This is a new question. And since we're given a large sample, how's my standard deviation? It's a sample standard deviation or a population standard deviation? It's a sample standard deviation, yes. If we have a sample standard deviation, then we should use D table or T table. T table. You're given a sample, then you should use the T table. All right. So now, let's go back to Excel template again. I only have two options for mu question, mu non and mu unknown. Right? Which one am I supposed to use?
Unknown.
Yes. Because in this template, I'm given a sample. I'm given a sample standard deviation here. Right? I cannot choose this table. Because this one does give me a sample standard deviation. I copy it and paste it. Format width 25 and less. 18
and
less.
Good. Yeah. My decision rule, if my
HO, reject HO, if my T stat is less than negative 1.68. Now, if you want to reject your HO, your T stat must be less than negative. T crit. My DF is 44. My alpha is 0.5. And this Q gives me 1.78. Alright. Step 4. What is my D? What is my T stat? Am I keeping my T stat? Also, yes. It's right here. -3.49. Cell reference, that is my T stat. Since negative 3.4 is less than negative 1.68, so reject HO. There is significant evidence to conclude repeat HA. My mu is less than 32. Alright, so what is my p-value for lower tail test? I removed it. Then what is my lower tail test p-value? 1 minus 0.9995. Yes. 1 minus 0.9995. How can I know I need 1 minus here? Because negative 3.49 is on the left side of your graph. Then the probability from there all the way to the left must be small. So there is no need for 1 minus in this case. You will have at least 2 questions like this one that will trick you on your exam too.